All right. Hi, everybody. We have just about 100 people on the line right now. So I'm going to go ahead and kick us off and get us started for the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless's first ever virtual variety show. As a heads up, I'm going to now be referring it to the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless as CCH moving forward. Just way easier to say, less of a mouthful, and I will be talking a lot tonight. So beginning now. CCH, that's what that means. If you are a longtime supporter of CCH, or if you are just hearing about us thanks to the show, we are so glad to have you on the line. If you live in the city of Chicago and understand the type of work that we do, or if you're from across the country, we are so, so glad to have you tune in and just really excited to get going on this. If you're a longtime supporter, you know that we have an associate board and I am the VP of events for that associate board, hence why I'm your host tonight. It's a young group of leaders who like to plan fundraising events just like this one. And in a time where it's very unusual, as you all know, and in-person events are not as safe as they once were, we decided to set out this year to go completely virtual and continue to raise money for the great work that the coalition does. So bear with us. As I mentioned, this is our first ever. I will continue to say that, hopefully to, you know, continue to remind you that we're hoping for smooth transitions. We're hoping that I don't trip over any of my words, but this is all of our first times doing this. So thank you for bearing with us. And I think we'll have a great time if everybody's all set and has a drink ready to go. I will just move to the next slide and tell you a little bit more about tonight's program. We have 12 great performances by over 12 people. We have 7 special guests, and you'll see more about those in a bit. But I want to pause right here on the 12 performers. Over the past 4 weeks, almost 5 weeks, they have been fundraising, and we had a goal of $10,000. And as of just a little bit ago, we are about $50 away from being at way over our goal, $14,000. So really, really exciting. Thank you to all of you, all of the contestants, supporters who are on the line, or if you just heard about this event randomly, we're so glad to have you here. And I think that deserves a round of applause. So if everybody wants to do that. Claire, my co-host, will be chatting the links to each of the participants as they perform to their individual fundraising pages to see if we can continue to get that number up. If you love a candidate, you love what they're doing, please go and support them there as their scores are actually dependent on their fundraising. So I also have the link to the Chicago Homeless Variety Show general page if you'd like to help the score increase and you don't have a specific person you're supporting. Would love to have you go there and do that. So like I said, we have 12 performances tonight. We have jugglers to comics to singers, and those very special seven guests who you might recognize from around the community, potentially on TV, given what your TV intake is and what you like to watch. But regardless, I would be remiss if I did not spend half of my time talking, thanking you all for being here and being our supporters. The work that CCH does is vital to the city, to the state, and it is an example for advocacy organizations everywhere and those who fight for homeless rights everywhere. So thank you again. Thank you. We could not do this without you. And before we dive into the show and the performances by each of our contestants, I wanted to introduce someone very special, Doug Schenkelberg, who is the executive director of CCH, to just put a face to the name and help everybody understand a bit more about the cause that you're here to support tonight.
Thank you so much, Sophie. It's great to be here tonight with all of you. You can see that the pandemic, like most people, has caused me to have a beard. Thank you so much to all of you for being part of this event. And I want to give a special shout out to Sophie for really spearheading this initiative, for producing it, for recruiting, for working with all of our associate board members and the performers. It's just an amazing event. The fact that we're already at almost $14,000 raised is just absolutely phenomenal. I want to thank all the members of the associate board for being part of this event. And I want to have special thanks to all the performers who are sharing their talents, sharing their networks of friends, who are bringing people to this event. It means a lot to us. Chicago Coalition for the Homeless You know, our mission is to organize and advocate to prevent and end homelessness because we believe housing is a human right. And we couldn't get it done without incredible partners. And those partners are the associate board members. There are the performers tonight. There's all of you who are watching. We take the word coalition seriously, and having all of you part of this work means that we can get things done. And in this year, which has been a hard year to say the least, it's important to have an opportunity to take a break. And tonight is a chance to take a break, have some fun, laugh a little, enjoy some music, enjoy performances, and to know that you're supporting a good cause. So thank you to everyone for taking the time to be part of this, for joining the community, and I say cheers to you all. Thank you, Sophie.
Thank you, Doug, and thank you to Michael and Claire. They are our go-to CCH staff members who work with us day in and day out to make sure that we have events like this that are fun and exciting and that truly support CCH. So I'm gonna go back to my slides and head on to the next one to just lay some ground rules. We're calling them house rules, as I think many of you know. In 2020, Zoom has become a lot of our second homes. It's funny, my sister just sent me a link to an article saying that Zoom is the number one app this year. So because we all have access to Zoom, we are very lucky to all be here tonight to be able to do a show like this. So I want everyone to kind of keep that in the back of their minds as they're watching. We all have the access to be entertaining ourselves like this, and a lot of people out there do not. So when I talk about the house rules, the first one is at the bottom that I want to mention, but I just want to get there first. Have fun. Like Doug said, we all need a break this year. And this is really what this is meant to be, just a fun break from everyday reality. And I think what CCH does at its core is very fun to be a part of. And as at least on the associate board, we like to have fun during our events. If you were with us in a normal year, we would be inviting you to come to a wine tasting or a yoga class or a rock climbing class. We really like to have events that are fun. So I hope at some point, you know, if you stay connected to CCH, we can invite you to one of those around the city, or maybe even continue to do things virtually. But more logistically, please stay on mute. You've all done a great job doing that. But with that being said, on the flip side, we do want you to react to performances. So we'd love to see your smiling faces. The gallery view will allow our judges to be able to understand how the audience is receiving performances. So it's really important that our comics get laughs, our singers get claps, and we even have some other interesting performances that we would love to see your reaction to. So please do that. Please go off mute when you can, as appropriate. We also want you to use Zoom's reaction buttons. If you don't know where they are, they're typically at the bottom of your screen. You can do a clap, you can do a thumbs up. We would love for you to do that when you like a performance. Please do support your favorite person performing. Like I said, audience receptivity is a part of the contestants' overall score, so please do use those reaction buttons. And in addition to that, use the chat box. You can say, hey, I loved your song, or what's your Instagram, or what is your, how did you come up with that stand-up set? You can ask questions to not only the performers, you can ask about the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless, and we do have people on the line who will be able to answer that as I'm here rambling to you all. It's also ideal, if you are not on Zoom as much as some of us, to switch to speaker view. Right now your view is probably just my slides because I'm sharing them, but once the performers start to perform, Claire, my lovely co-host, will be spotlighting those performers. And if you're on speaker view, it might just make it easier to see them. But again, have fun. That's what this event is about, and we're very excited to get started. But before we get started, we have our judges, and they are all distinguished volunteers and staff members of CCH who are not as intimidating, I promise, as they appear in their very professional LinkedIn photos that I stole without asking them. But they include two presidents of CCH's board of directors and associate board, Karenina Grimble and Sarah Swankowski, if you want to give a wave. We have two CCH staff members, community organizers Keith Freeman and Bisma Shukat. And we have four members of the CCH Associate Board Leadership Team, Morgan White, Ebony Thompson, Lindsay Welbers, and Patrick Gilsonen. All of these people have taken time out of their days to do something very fun, but for CCH in judging this this show. So thank you all for being here. These judges will be scoring our contestants out of 40 points. So everybody has heard me say a couple times now that part of those points are fundraising. Fundraising scores will be developed at the very end. So they'll have a score out of 10, and it's based on, you know, the top score being one 10-point lead, and then every score after that divided by that top score. Originality is another scoring factor. We love that we have such various performers here tonight. We have a butcher. If you're a vegetarian, shield your eyes. I will make that joke again when I introduce him. We have an overall score for audience receptivity. So like I said, please use your reactions. We really want this to be engaging, as well as overall performance. So each contestant will get an overall score out of 40, and we will announce the winners in terms of top three. So the third place winner, second place winner, first place winner. We will also have a trophy for our top fundraiser. So there is that as well. And then we will have a general wall of fame. So if our contestants have raised over $1,000, they will get onto the wall of fame. I think I want to take this moment to have Michael be our Vanna White for right now and show us the trophies if he has those available.
Michael? Look at this beauty. Isn't this beautiful? I don't know, that's too much of a glare, but I would love to have this on my mantle. Oh, there you go. Chicago Coalition for the Homeless. You're a winner. You're all winners for raising money, but only a couple people are going to take one of these home.
So that is what they're in it for, and that is what our contestants are vying to win, as well as just the general notoriety of being a great person. I'm going to move to the next slide and let you know that I kind of alluded to this, but we do have some special guests throughout the performance and throughout the night. We'll be hearing from arguably B or C list stars from various walks of life. You might have seen them on TV, you might have seen them around the community, but they have all fulfilled our cameo requests, and they will be hyping up the crowd throughout the night. So without further ado, we'll hear from our first star, Danny Trejo, who's best known for his performance in Breaking Bad. And in this video, he looks about as tired as we all have felt this whole year. So I think we'll all be able to relate.
My name is Danny Trejo. First of all, I want to thank the Chicago Homeless Coalition for all the wonderful work they do. Let's everybody, man, participate in their upcoming events. God bless you. You guys are on the front line. Special place in heaven for you.
So you heard the man. With the wise words of Danny Trejo under our belts, it is showtime, and I'm going to move to the next slide.
My name is Danny Trejo.
I knew that would happen at least once. It's showtime. Going to move to the next slide to introduce our first contestant, Alicia Norris, who is a singer, a Chicago area advocate, and activist for social justice. Alicia, I'm going to stop sharing my screen and say hello. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Thank you for being our first Brave performer. I knew I could count on you to kick off the show. You've been involved in CCH and as an associate board member yourself, so you know what you're in for. What made you want to get involved in CCH originally?
I used to be in an outreach program through my church, and I've just always really had a heart for it. I believe that this work that you guys are doing is literally God's love in action. So it's really motivated me to be, you know, more in the fold, making impact. And what better way than joining your guys' organization or group or associate board, because you guys are literally doing so much every day. So, yeah.
Awesome. Well, yeah. I love that answer. And I love the work that CCH does as well. And I think we all have that in common. So without further ado, I'll let you take it away.
Cool. Thank you, Sophie. First one on the list. The song I'm going to sing is called Rise Up by Andra Day. Can everybody hear me okay? Good? Okay, cool. And the lyrics of the song really embody like what it means to stand in the gap for somebody, to show up for somebody. And it really emulates too what this organization is all about, and the amazing work that they They do. And I think this is also a call to action for everybody to rise up. We see all the injustices that happen every single day. And so thank you everybody for answering the call and jumping on here to enjoy the night. And then I also just kind of want to hope the song encourages everybody to rise up in our own spirits. There's, you know, dark days and we all have bad days, but just kind of, rising up and staying encouraged that every day is a day to get it right and start again.
You're broken down and tired, living life on a merry-go-round. You can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we're gonna walk it out and move mountains. We're gonna walk it out and move mountains. I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up, rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. I'll rise up, high like the waves. I'll rise up, in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. For you, you, for you, the silence is quiet, and it feels like it's hard to breathe. I know you feel like dying. I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Mountains bring it to its feet.
So much, guys.
Awesome. Well, what a way to start the show. going to move back to my slides. I think you had a lot of people tearing up, Alicia. Thank you for that. So before we move into our next performance, we will now hear a word from a true Chicago all-star and someone best known for his role in the friendly confines of Wrigley Field in the late 90s and early 2000s.
Hey, Chicago Coalition, this is former Major League pitcher John Lieber, played with the Cubs for 5 years. I don't know if some of you might remember me, some of you might not, but that's okay. But I am doing this cameo specifically for you guys, and this was booked by Ellen. And she wanted me to thank you guys for all the work that you do for the homeless in the great state of Illinois. It sounds like you guys are a tremendous group. You put up a lot of time, a lot of effort to work with people, and I'm gonna tell you right now, that's not easy. I've done that over the years when I was playing, and I respect and admire all the work you guys do. So I think that's tremendous. As well as the hype that that you're putting in for participants, I guess, in an upcoming virtual variety show fundraiser. And it sounds like a really big thing. It sounds like it's pretty cool. I've never said anything like that, but anyway, I think it was really cool when Ellen sent this in, and she really put it in detail what you guys do, and I don't think a lot of other people realize all the work that you guys do for the homeless and trying to raise money. And I just want to say, you know, thank you. And I'm very, very proud of the time and effort that you do for those people out there that are less fortunate to not, you know, be able to be where we're at or whatever. But anyway, this cameo is for you. Love you guys. Keep working hard. And I want to hear about all the good things and all the success that goes in with it. All right. Talk to you later.
Go Cubs go. So someone get John Lieber on the phone and let him know he's at the show that he was talking about and come join us. Thank you, Ellen. I know he mentioned your names a couple times. Ellen O'Brien, a member of our associate board, for purchasing that cameo for us.
Hey, sure.
Our next contestant, our second performance of the night, will come from Amber Autry. Amber is a nationally touring comedian that brings an electric energy to the stage. I have to ask, Amber, is the cat performing with you?
Unfortunately not. He's booked on another gig. He's in high demand, so.
Okay. All right. Well, with that, I'll let you take it away.
Awesome. Hello, everybody. Man, it is so good to be here. Hi. Everybody who has their cameras on looks nice. Good job pretending like you haven't been wearing the same thing for 9 months. Look at you go. I've been wearing this shirt for a while. Like a long time. Like, I just sent a spreadsheet, like a style spreadsheet to my neighbors. Like, I'm going out on Tuesdays and Thursdays. I'm going to need y'all guys to pick a different day so we don't embarrass ourselves, okay? I don't know about you guys, but the people in my neighborhood are acting wild because they miss human interaction, right? So they're doing crazy things. Like, one of my neighbors, she's decided to post riddles on her window in order to engage. I know. She got me, dude. She got me. I stopped by the other day, and I was like, wow. That's not the answer I expected. This woman lifts her window, sticks her head out, and was like, what did you expect? Oh, not that. You can't just surprise communicate with people, lady. It's not that I don't want to talk to humans. It's that I don't want to talk to humans that like riddles. You know, it's the most useless information. Like, and riddle people are so aggressive. They're like, do you give up yet? Do you give up yet? You give up yet? And finally, when you do, you're like, yes, what's the answer? They're like, the horse was named Tuesday. That's such a waste of everybody. It's like handing someone the aux cord and then playing podcasts for hours. It's like, we get it. You're smart. Okay. We get it. This is amazing. I honestly love Zoom comedy so much. I haven't cared about my internet connection this much since high school when all my boyfriends lived online. Oh man. Wasn't that an exciting time? Those were great relationships, man. They really were. They'd be like, how's your day? I'm like, oh, normal 16-year-old stuff. How's your day? They're like, oh, normal 30-year-old. I mean, 16-year-old stuff. gotta go put my kids to bed. I know some of that. I know that may make you feel uncomfortable, but let me just say it's fine. It was actually a blessing to have a lot of internet boyfriends because I didn't get pregnant too early. And being from the South, that is from God, you know? Like, we had so many pregnant girls in our high school that eventually it just became the mascot. You know, like, you didn't know if someone was pregnant or just had a lot of school spirit. So I'm very grateful. I've been an early riser lately. I've been trying to get up early. Greek success at the door, you know? I'm realizing that I don't have the budget for success, though. I wake up at 6 a.m. I'm hungry again by 6:15 a.m. I'm like, well, this is not sustainable. I try to take a nap because I can't afford to eat. And naps don't hit like they used to in kindergarten, man. They really don't. I wish I would have appreciated them then. Because naps now, I wake up and I'm more tired. Like, my body's in more pain. I think it's my body's way of saying, of like, I can get you at any moment. Like, live life to the fullest because it's almost the end. I just bought a car with my boyfriend, which is very exciting. That's why I'm broke, by the way. It is my own fault. I will admit to that. And it's interesting. My boyfriend was like, you know what I've discovered is that no matter what mode of transportation you're in, you're always upset. We're in a car. You're mad at people on a bike. We're on a bike. You're mad at pedestrians. I'm like, well, a little bit of advice. You might want to use your blinker if you're going to turn on somebody. Honestly, have never expected that kind of behavior from someone who says they love me, really. That's why I think they need road signs for passengers, right? To keep them occupied. Things that say like, breathe, trust your driver.
He'll
slow down once the Xanax gets in. It's going to be fine. My mom is no better. The other night she got drunk off of 2 beers, which she was able to safely drive home from the passenger seat. So excited about those comments. And even though I already had the address typed into my GPS, she insisted on putting it into hers. So I had the address relayed to me 3 times. So the phones were like, turn right on Gary Avenue, turn right on Gary Avenue. And then my mom, you're gonna wanna turn right on Gary Avenue. And the worst part about this is that each messenger pronounced words differently. So my phone was like, slight ride on James White Parkway, my mom's phone, sly rye on James White Ply. And then my mom like, sly over, I'm gonna puke. I'm like, okay, mom, all right, this is enough, you know? Eventually I just had to change the directions entirely. My phone was like rerouting, her phone rerouting, and me being like, final destination, old folks home. Get on out, mama. They're gonna take good care of you here, okay? I'll end on this, guys. You guys ever notice that the phrase not gonna lie is usually followed up by something that's not worth lying about? You know, people will be like, I'm not gonna lie, I do prefer mayonnaise to mustard. It's like, okay, Brad, when are you not gonna lie about cheating on your spouse? Okay. Subway is a sacred spot, and we need you to stop coming to lunch with us. Okay, thank you. All right, guys, my name is Amber Autry. You've been a great crowd. If you like my set, follow me on Instagram. Back to Sophie. Thank you.
Amazing. I mean it when I say to go off of mute and laugh if you would like to. Woo!
Very topical.
Very good. Awesome. Love it. Thank you, Amber. Still this much bitter that we didn't get to meet your cat, but maybe next time.
Yes, for sure.
All right, I'm heading back to my screen for a special guest once again. As if 2020 was not going to be weird enough, Netflix actually dropped a show in around early February, late March timeframe that made you all think that they would have known that quarantine was about to happen. Show was called Love is Blind, and people could only meet their spouse in a pod and didn't get to see them until they proposed. So I'm going to introduce to you our next special guest, who was probably one of the most hated people on the show, actually, but he has a great message for all of you tonight.
What's going on, everyone over at the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless? It's Barnett here from Love is Blind. I wanted to say you guys are doing amazing, amazing work over there, making sure that everyone can have the right to housing over in Illinois. And I also wanted to say a way to go to everybody that's participating in the virtual variety show. You're sharing all your talents, your amazing, amazing talents to raise money for a great cause. So way to go, guys. Keep it up. See you around.
Don't you love how all of these cameos are people in their cars? Like, I don't know where they're going. It's 2020 still. Thank you, Catherine Wainwright, for purchasing that. Another associate board member. Love to hear from Barnett. And next up for our performers, we have Chloe, who has been playing the piano since she was young and loves playing cover songs. I believe she'll be playing one tonight. Hi, Chloe.
Hi.
I'm restraining from making a Big Ten joke that literally nobody will care about unless you went to Purdue.
God bless. Nervous enough.
Yeah. And instead, I'm going to ask you just quickly, what are you going to be singing for us tonight?
That was an easy one. Thank you. I'm going to be singing Leave On by Elton John. And I'm gonna also dedicate it to my roommate. It's her birthday. She's watching upstairs. And to my parents. And thank you everyone for supporting.
I love that you donated it or said it was for your roommates who have to probably listen to you practice it as well.
So, yeah. Very all right. Here goes nothing. Wait, I should probably pull up the lyrics, right? Okay. Live on, no. Guys, it's smart to have your keyboard plugged in, right? Okay. Live on, where's this wobble like a crown? He calls his child Jesus. Because he likes the name. And he sends him to the finest school in town. Levon likes his money. He makes a lot, they say. Spends his days counting in a garage by the motorway. He was born a barber to a pawn on a Christmas day when the New York Times said God is dead and the war's begun. Leventastic has a son today, and he shall be Levon, and he shall be a good man, and he shall be Levon. In tradition to the family plan, and he shall be Levon, and he shall be a good man. He shall be Levon. Levon sells cartoon balloons in town. His family business thrives. Jesus blows up balloons all day. Sits on the porch swing watching them fly. And Jesus, he wants to go to Venus. Leave on far behind. Take a balloon and go sailing while Levon slowly dies. He was born a pauper to a pawn on a Christmas day when the New York Times said God is dead and the war's begun. Leventastic has a son today, and he shall be Levon. And he shall be a good man, and he shall be Levon, in tradition with the family plan. And he shall be Levon, and he shall be a good man. He shall be Levon, and he shall be Levon, and he shall be a good man. And he shall be Levon, in tradition with the family plan. And he shall be Levon, and he shall be a good man. he shall believe on.
All right, that was it. Judges, don't judge the keyboard. Do the singing more.
Woo-hoo!
Woo! Nice.
Yeah, Chloe!
Awesome. Thank you, Chloe. It's so fun to hear you sing, and I'm sure your roommates are cheersing from upstairs. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm going to go back to my screen share now and introduce our fourth contestant. Moving right along, we have John. John is one of two Johns that we have in the show tonight. So this is John R. He is a passionate and globally engaged university grad currently based in Chicago with many skills, one of which being juggling. So John, you're up, but I have to ask, when did you learn to juggle? I assume it's just when you came out of the womb because your name is John and John the juggler just fits, but you let us know.
Yeah, it was fifth grade and I learned in one day.
What?
I did it for like 8 hours straight and it's like riding a bike. I'll never forget it.
I love it. Well, congrats on your awesome talent that not a lot of people can do for a show like this. So very excited to kick it over to you.
All right, let's do it.
Juggle that, yeah.
Woo!
Are those Slinkies?
Let's go, Johnny.
Woo!
Woo!
Let's go, John.
That's the ornaments. Minutes and you just said, well, then I'll juggle everything in my house. That is amazing. Honestly, your juggling reminds me of all of us trying to balance our lives this year and trying to do that in the year of COVID-19. You did a better job than I think we all have been doing. That was amazing.
Well, thank you.
Thank you. All right. I doubt most of us or many of us have been to a wedding in a few months, hopefully not, but our next special guest needs no introduction, as at said weddings, you've likely grabbed your grandma and gotten down to his hit song on the dance floor a time or two.
What up, what up, what up, what up, what up? This is Mr. Down, down, do your dance, do your dance. Down, down, do your dance, do your dance. What's up? This is Cupid, y'all. I would like to say thanks, big thanks, to the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless for the great work that you guys do for Chicago. And I also want to hype y'all up and get y'all pumped up for the first ever virtual variety show fundraiser. I heard it's going down. I heard y'all going to be sharing y'all talents to raise money. I want to see, a matter of fact, tag me on my Instagram, Official New Cupid, if you got videos from this variety show. I got to see this. You know what I'm saying? So my Instagram is Official New Cupid. Tag me. I got to see it, man. Shout out to all y'all, man, and much love. And until I see y'all live, it's going to be a down, down, do your dance, new style, yeah. New Cupid.
Just a quick check. Can everybody see my screen? I want to make sure that, okay, perfect. That, you know, the classic one-hit wonder. I have no idea if he has any other songs besides the Cupid Shuffle, but I'm going to move right along and give, before we move on to our next performance, the floor to Patrick, who has a fundraising update for us. I think I misspoke when we were about to start the show. I think we were already at $14,000, and I would love to know where we are at now.
We were really close, and we definitely passed it up. We're at $14,610 right now. So great job, people. They're coming in as you guys are performing. So everybody's performances are that good. Keep it up. And I'm sure we're going to do even better. At this point, 15,000 looks not only within reach, but I'm optimistic. I think you guys can pull it off. And also, for the record, Cupid tells us he has something coming. So I believe him.
Amazing. Well, look at that. You guys, just in the past few minutes, we've raised that much money. That's just the power of everybody coming together to have fun and raise money for an awesome cause like this. So thank you, Patrick, for that update. Hopefully we'll come back to you for another update later in the night. We're gonna move on to our next performance, hopefully to get the Cupid Shuffle out of everybody's heads. We're moving on to Jenny Case, who grew up in New Orleans and then Findlay, Ohio. And she's one of my good friends, in full transparency. So I'm going to try to keep this pass off a little shorter than many of our wine nights are. And just ask you this, Jenny. I know you've been playing the ukulele a little bit lately, but since when did you get this talent?
So that's actually funny, Sophie. At the beginning of, I notoriously didn't play an instrument in college, which was funny because I majored in musical theater. Shout out to IUMT if you're watching. But at the beginning of quarantine, my best friend Taylor, who's my roommate, actually, she's like standing right there. She's a first grade teacher and she got a ukulele. And I was like, well, okay, I kind of want a ukulele. And so it's just kind of been the thing that I've been toying around with during quarantine. But it's very rudimentary. Like, it's not anything impressive. So it's just going to accompany me very lightly tonight.
Your ukulele might be very lightly accompanying your amazing voice, so take it away.
Thank you. Okay, so this is, if you know me, you know I love Lady Gaga. So this is A Million Reasons.
You're giving me a million reasons to let you go. You're giving me a million reasons to quit the show. You're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. If I had a highway, I would run for the hills. If you could find a driveway, I'd forever be still. You're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons I bow down to pray. I try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn out leather. I've got 100 million reasons to walk away, but baby, I just need one good one to stay. Heads hooked in a cycle, I look off and I stare. It's like that I've stopped breathing, but completely aware. Cause you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. about a million reasons. And if you say something that you might even mean, it's hard to even fathom which part I should believe. Cause you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. I bow down to pray. I try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn out leather. I've got 100 million reasons to walk away. But baby, I just need one good one to stay. Well, baby, I'm bleeding, bleeding. Can't you give me what I'm needing, needing? Every heartbreak makes it hard to keep the faith. But baby, I just need one good one, good one, good one, good one. When I bow down to pray, I try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn out leather. I've got 100 million reasons to walk away. But baby, I just need one good one, good one. Tell me that you'll be the good one, good one. Baby, I just need one good one to stay.
Woo!
Thank you, guys. Woo!
Hey.
From TikTok to virtual shows, they grow up so fast. Thank you, Jenny.
Sophie, proud of you.
All right. Can everyone see my slides now? I know there was a little bit of difficulty from some people, so hopefully everybody can see my slides. All right, our next contestants, they're a group. So it's a performance, a group of friendly faces formed by David Swenson, one of our associate board leaders. He's the outreach chair. And he's gonna show off a bit of friendly competition with his friends in a girls versus boys pie eating contest. So this group is all in separate places. There's three places that they will be participating in this pie eating contest. So you'll see the spotlight move from one to the other, or you can switch to gallery view and see all of the Brady Bunch squares to watch them eat their pies. The best part, I think, is that they will be donating pies to their local pantry as a part of this program. And the other best part is that this group claims that they had no talent and this was all that they could do. Yet they managed to successfully create a competition within a competition, and I'm calling that the variety showception. So David, you and your team have absolutely blown away the fundraising pages in the last few weeks. We're so excited to see all that is to come in terms of pie eating right now. So with that, I'll pass it over to you.
Hi everyone. We just wanted to say thank you for having us today. And, you know, we are probably not the most talented group that you're going to see here tonight. Definitely not the most talented group you're going to see here tonight. But everyone here is very committed to this cause. And we just wanted to raise money for this great cause. So without further ado, you're going to see a team of three boys and three girls in a pie eating contest. So we appreciate everyone's participation in this event.
You got it, David. Woo!
All right. Hopefully the booth women are ready. So we're gonna count down from 10, and then we are eating. We're each eating 1/3 of a Costco pie. And as Sophie said, only three pies were harmed in the making of this. And for each $100 raised, we're donating one pie to a local food bank. So there will be 30 pies donated, or 40 pies actually donated for the holidays. So I'll actually count down for five. Ten seems too long. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Woo! Woo!
Oh,
You gotta eat faster.
Eat, 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 eat.
Work? Oh my god, that's so much pie.
I hope you're timing this because I'm not, David.
Oops, there goes my crust.
I'm gonna finish half a pie if you eat that slow.
We have 5 minutes. No, wow, there it
is. Amazing.
Should we go on mute so we can hear your seat?
Keep going.
Yeah, no. It's a lot. Chrissy, how you doing? Girls rule. Okay, maybe graduate to 4.
That was pretty good.
I'm starting to sweat a little bit. Whoa!
Is everyone feeling okay?
Yes!
Oh, whoever said we should have had whipped cream, that would have been.
Oh, my God.
Housing that pie.
I hope it's at least a good pie.
More bad than expected. We thought this was going to be easy. Definitely easy.
I feel like Sean.
Amanda. Yeah. Shove it in. Oh, look, he's almost done.
Yeah. Oh my god, Pat! You're good at this.
She's the biggest guy.
Power move.
Okay, second anymore.
Are you done, David? It looks like David's done. No? Shove it in.
I'm done.
No. Let's go.
The guys. We saw that.
Sean, let's go. Let's go. Do it. Say it. Done.
David's last.
Oh my god.
They've been walking away.
I need to know if the pink lady is a hippo.
He was the first one to finish. He's done. Look at that stomach.
Eat the pot!
Eat
the
pot! Yeah!
I know.
I spoiled on myself.
I have no idea how to moderate this, so you're gonna have to tell me who's the winner.
All right, do we want to call it?
No. David needs to finish his pie.
Yeah. Somebody has to finish.
David is slow.
I'm slowing down.
I can't do it.
All right.
How much do you have left, David? Show us how much you have left.
He's left.
Oh man.
That's a lot of pie.
One piece. Wait, how much do you guys have left? Stop it right now. How much you have left?
We have.
Oh.
If you guys were willing to call it that we win, we'll call it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The guys win.
Chrissy, how much do you have?
Like the same.
Thank you so much for indulging us. This was very silly, but it was just to raise money for an important cause, and we're all really committed to the cause, so we appreciate everyone indulging.
Like Jumanji.
Very silly things, and it turns out that, you know, Sean and Pat can eat pies. So thank you so much, and thanks for
having me.
Enjoy. joining today. Thank you.
Thank you.
Nicely done.
That was hilarious. I love Clive. I do not love Clive that much.
Yeah, point the fire when he gets here.
I should ask him if he's just like a pumpkin pie. Yeah.
I understand if you all need to go lay down from the pie eater group. We will move the show right along. I'm going to share my screen again and introduce our next special guest. And though we have a few singers in tonight's variety show, few would want or, you know, invite the type of stardom that this man did in his audition for one of the earlier seasons of American Idol. So if you remember him like I do, it will be great to hear from him tonight.
Hello, Chicago Coalition for the Homeless. This is William Hung from American Idol. Thank you for all the amazing work that you do for Illinois to help those less fortunate. Here is a special song for you. She bangs, oh baby, when she moves, I go crazy cause she loves like a flower, but she stings like a bee. Like every girl in history, you bang.
Again, I just love that all of the cameos are based in their cars. I really don't understand. So I'm gonna move us right along to our next contestant.
Hello.
Gotta figure out how to not play the video twice. Our next contestant is the second John of the evening, but he will be doing a separate talent from John the Juggler. And he's been living in Chicago since 2016 after originally hailing from Buffalo. And he says he's been spending most of 2020 strumming his guitar in his bedroom, but is thrilled to be able to perform to an actual live audience for once. John, hello, are you ready to go?
Hello, yeah. What's up, Sophie?
Well, what made you want to get involved in this type of fundraiser?
My friend Jack Reedy does some work with you guys. And so shout out to Jack, who I think hooked a couple of us here. Helpful. My family back home in Buffalo is watching right now. So saying hello to them. So just talking with Jack about the work he's doing and then about just, you know, what's needed this winter to help you guys out. So we're all happy to be here part of this. I'm singing a Christmas song for you guys today. In this room here, I've been recording this, gonna put up a version of this track on Bandcamp, try to raise more money. So I think after I post all these links, I'll make sure that's shared, and then we'll kind of keep this fundraising going, coming out of this. That's all I got.
Take it away, John. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
So we love everybody associated with Jack. Thank you.
Thank you.
I remember when you were here. All the fun we had last year. There was a way I'd hold back these tears. It's Christmas Day. Please, 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 please come home.
Yay, yay!
Thank you. I'll take my jingle slippers off right now.
Wait, keep those up. You had your jingle happening in your slippers?
Yeah, it's just the slippers are always on these days. And sometimes you need to jingle. So sometimes you need to put the jingle on the slippers. That's just how it works when you have a Christmas song to sing for charity.
I love that so much. And you said that song is going to be for sale to donate all of the proceeds to Chicago Coalition for the Homeless?
100%. Yep. It'll be up on Bandcamp. I'm thinking, and I'm working at that now. A little bit of technical issues this week with a laptop fried. So I'm happy we're able to kind of put this whole show together. So yeah, we're getting that track together. It's going to be out on, so like all month, we'll try to raise some money for that too. So yeah.
That is amazing. Thank you again.
Thank you all. Yep.
Awesome. Thank you, John. I'm going to go back to sharing my screen here. Up next, I believe we have another Jack Reedy.
Thank you.
Liz is a writer and a performer in the Chicago area, and she's going to be performing some stand-up for us tonight. So without further ado, Liz, are you ready for this?
Hell yeah, let's do it.
Woo!
Woo! All right. Woo, Liz, let's go!
So hi, everybody. thanks for tuning in. Thanks for donating. I'm here in New York City, and it's just been the best year ever over here. I'm wearing this because this is what I'm going to wear to shows now. There's no rules anymore. This is what I wear now. I'm here with a couple of friends. Don't worry, just like 75 of my closest friends, socially distanced. It's like all good. Yeah, man, so this year sucks like a lot, and it's really been like radicalizing for a lot of people, which I think is funny because a lot of people say, oh, you'll get more conservative as you get older. I have overall not found that to be the case, but there is one thing that I am realizing that I'm actually really conservative about. And I realized it when I saw a headline this summer about Sean Penn getting married. Good for him. But his wife, his new wife, is younger than his daughter. And not to sound like a Republican being like, there are just natural laws that we have to abide by. But I think that if you have to break the laws of time and space to make your family genealogy make sense, I think the state should intervene. But like, at least he's found love a couple times. Good for him. More than I can say for myself, and which was true before this year, but now I have a convenient excuse. So this, I hate the apps. I don't know anyone who likes them. That's not true. I do. Some of them are in this room. They're sociopathic. And I do not like them at all. I hate being on Hinge. It bums me out because I always think about like people's parents and how you just like give birth to someone and you like, you see the miracle of human life and you invest your heart and soul into raising them and you like teach them how to read and walk and ride a bike. And you spend, by this point, it's been like a quarter of a century, this labor of love. And it takes us half a second to be like, weird mouth, I'm not interested, and just swipe. It's like, I'm actually not interested in getting to know this person on any level whatsoever. And if they died tomorrow, I really wouldn't care. I wish that I was on Raya. That's like the app for famous people or rich people. And I just like, it seems super high concept, super like exclusive. It's really hard to get into. And I would just really like, if I have to invest all this time in online dating, I want it to end with me getting murdered by like the son of some disgraced Danish count in international airspace. And he could and should get away with it. If I have to do this, I want it to culminate in an interesting death. That's what I deserve. Some of my friends here tonight, we went to high school together and they've never seen me do stand-up before. And because I started after high school, but you saw me do plenty of stupid stuff in high school. And one thing that we all did together was we went to a Catholic all-girls high school, uniforms, the whole deal. And we used to skip liturgy. We hated going, being forced to go to mass. And so we would, when we were all walking down, we would cut off, like break away from the line and go hide in this little like secret room that was basically a pitch black hallway behind our televisions. We had a television studio in the school, and we would just like sneak in there and turn off all the lights. You would make sure that everyone had made it. It'd be like, where's Alana? Where's Alana? Oh man, they got her. They got her. She didn't make it. She didn't make it, dude. We lost her. And so once we had accounted for everyone, we would sit there in complete silence, would not turn on any lights, would not like let anyone open a laptop or something. It's like, they're gonna see the light. They're gonna see the light under the door, man. You can't do that. And it's, why didn't we just go to mass? Like, we sat in total darkness, complete silence for like an hour and a half. And we voluntarily did the thing that you do when there's like a school shooter. Like, we chose that. Speaking of school shooters, I majored in film and television in college, which is arguably worse than being a school shooter. And one time we had to film on campus, and I sent like a permission request, like, hey, I need a permit. Can we shoot on this location? And my professor emailed back and they were like, yes, totally, no problem. Maybe next time don't make the subject of your email shooting on campus. We were about to make some phone calls. I forgot to hit a timer, so I don't know how long that was, but that's all I got.
We love you, Liz.
My friend.
Thank you guys. Thank you so much for donating. This is an awesome cause. This year has been total garbage for everyone, and especially people experiencing homelessness. So this is a great group of people, and I am so proud of the work everybody's done. Thanks for letting me be part of it. Shout out to Jack Reedy.
Yes. Thank you so much, Liz. Honestly, I had heard you were so funny, and I'm so glad to hear it in action. And please do let us know where you're performing when we can finally get off of virtual comedy, which I know is probably an oxymoron in the sense of things that you can't even hear anybody react. But I'm glad you had some friends on set with you. That was prime time to have them laughing in the background like a true laugh track.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thanks, Sophie.
Thanks, Liz. All right, I'm going back to my
ring.
Getting a little bit of an echo, so I don't know if everybody's on mute, but I think we're good now. Can everybody see my screen? Just looking for some thumbs up. Thank you, Holly, first person I saw. Here we go again with a special guest. We did promise you all talent tonight, not touchdowns. So let's hear a quick word from our mostly practice squad NFL player who, you know, on the bright side has likely been, or maybe dark side, depending on who you are, has been in the room with some more famous people like Tom Brady this year.
Hi, it's wide receiver Cyril Grayson with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And I just want to show some appreciation to all the members that's a part of the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless. It says so much about a person when they'll do something for someone who can't do something for them in return. So just continue to be the great people that you are, being amazing, making changes, continue to advocate for changes and get things done. And as y'all's last event for the year is coming up, the virtual variety show, I wanna say good luck to everyone who's participating. I know everyone can't wait to see how creative you guys can get, showing your talent, and just be great, and I hope that you raise all the money possible, because we know that you need it to continue to do the great things that you guys are doing. So stay the course and be blessed.
Thank you, Cyril Grayson. So without further ado, I'm going to again play the video twice because I cannot figure out how my PowerPoint doesn't let me do that. I'm going to kick it over to Patrick again, as I know we've been trying to raise money throughout the night. We started with just under 14,000. I know his last update, we had increased that, and I want to know where we're at now.
Yeah, no, we are now just under 15,000. So we're at 14,770. You guys are doing great. People are donating throughout the night, and I want to encourage that. We can break 15,000, guys. And, you know, just like how great everybody's being, as a group, we can do great things. So yeah, no, thank you guys. Keep it up. This is going great.
Thank you, Patrick. Amazing. I can't believe, you know, we set out with a big goal of raising $10,000 in a completely virtual environment where we were just relying on people many of us had never met before, and everybody has truly come together to make this happen. So excited. And with that, we have three performances left. And next up, we have Catalina, who is a singer-songwriter living in Chicago. Her music explores the highs and lows of life and love, which honestly, to me, sounds like the way that 2020 would write their autobiography. So, Kat, I understand that you are singing an original song. Is that correct?
Yes, I am.
Awesome. Well, I'm going to give it over to you with my last question just being, what influences your music?
Yeah. I would say a lot of different things. I really like indie rock music and like indie pop. So I really like Maggie Rogers. She's awesome. I don't know if anyone's a fan of her, but I'd say like she's a big influence. So yeah, like thank you for having me. I'm really excited. Can you guys hear me okay if I just play? Can you hear that?
Perfect.
So yeah, I'm gonna be playing in a song that I wrote. And it is called Bottleneck.
Ooh. Where can we hear that again?
Working on that. So yeah, I'll hopefully we'll be recording it in the next few months. So definitely want to put it on like SoundCloud or something.
That was beautiful. I think everybody here can agree that we would all like to hear that again and have that on our phones to just play whenever we can. Thank you so much for doing this and being here tonight. So appreciate you.
Yes, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Awesome. Well, that was Catalina with her beautiful original song. And now we're going to move into our 10th performer, which is completely different than anything that you've seen tonight. And I'm excited to welcome Mitch, who works at Chicago's Girl and the Goat. And he's going to show off some butcher skills tonight. So again, I told you earlier I would make this joke again. If you're a vegetarian, it might be best to close your eyes at this point. Mitch, I am curious, do you typically butcher meat on camera, or is this a first timer for you?
This would be a first time live for me for sure. So I'm a little nervous. I have a sharp knife with me. Who knows? We'll see.
Okay. Well, without further ado, take it away, my friend.
Okay. Hey, so like everybody said, my name's Mitch. I'm head butcher at Girl and the Goat in Chicago. So let's start off right off. This is a pig head. Now, like I said, my talent's butchery. It's not videography, so you're going to have to bear with me as I cut this meat off this guy for you. Now, first cut I'm going to make is we're going to go right down the chin line and just go straight to the base. And once we're there, we're just going to separate the jaw all the way down on both sides, right until we get it to the cheek. Cheek's great meat, by the way. Surprisingly, Hannibal Lecter's favorite cut, if you've ever read the books. But that's either here or there. Now that we've opened it up, though, if you guys have ever seen the movie Predator, this is a great example of what that movie was like. And we're going to flip it over now. And we're going to cut the cheeks clean from the bone so we get all that meat, which I was talking about. Now that it's clean, I'm going to go right down the top of the skull. Start to clean all this meat off, go right down the jowl, finish up along the snout. As you guys can see, I'm getting this nice head flat and getting as much of this meat off the bone as I can. Trying to get it, I'm getting most of it, so it's pretty good so far. I'm gonna flip it over, do the exact same thing on the other side. Just clean it up much around this cheek as I can. I'm trying to keep it in focus. I hope I am. I'm just going all the way down. Clean up as I go. This triangle is a little bit tricky for me because it's my opposite hand. Now we're going a little bit fast, but normally in the restaurant when we're doing this, we do about 30 to up to 80 a week. So my best guy, who isn't me, honestly, do this one of these heads in about 3 minutes. I'm hoping for 5 today. So we'll see.
Are you yawning while you're doing this?
What was that?
I said, are you yawning while you're doing this? It's so easy for you.
I mean, I'm a little tired right now. I mean,
unlike the other performers, I'm not showing off so much a hidden talent as I'm just working from home. So I'm doing my best. But yeah, this is kind of something, you know, like I said, I do about 30 or 40 of these a week. And I try to do it as quick as possible there because that just gets me back here quicker. Unhappily for my girlfriend, though, I am now working from home. So right now, we're just going right down the snout. And I'm just trying to get as much as I can. You can see I'm getting mostly bone. I've left a little bit of skin here, but that's okay. And now I'm at the base of the snout. Just going to clean it up all the way around. And now I've exposed the snout. And hopefully I can clean it up and just get it all off in one go. Just like that, I got all the snout behind me. So right there, we'll stop for a second and just show off. This is a pig face, all intact. So now, put that aside for a second. There's a couple more little bits of meat we can get off this guy. Right now, I think we'll just go for the tongue, just so we can show off a more interesting cut in a second. Right now, we're just gonna pull the tongue right out of the back. Expose it and go in with the knife. Just cut around and pull it out. Get the last couple little bits. And now, pig tongue. Now we'll set all this on our cutting board. And for our last little bit, we'll use a magic cooking demo oven. And I'm gonna use that to get the pig brain out. So real quick, we'll put it inside. And remembering, magic cooking down a oven shrinks cutting boards. This is our pig brain. Little tiny guy for all of us to see. And that's it, that's breaking down a pig skull. Wow. Thanks guys, and thanks to everybody that actually has talent and showed up tonight. John Recchia, I have 3 pig skulls for you if you want to toss them around. Thanks, guys.
Wow, thank you.
Thank you, Mitch.
That was amazing.
Oh my gosh. So different from any of our other talents. We so appreciate you even taking the time to do that on camera for us. I know you mentioned that happens every day in your restaurant. We had a question come in from the chat. What are you going to do with the pig face? I think you're on.
Sorry, I muted myself right afterwards. What I'm gonna do personally is I'm going to cut the jowl down on both sides, which is the lower part right along the jaw right here. And I'm gonna cure it and I'm gonna make guanciale at home.
No.
And then with the cheek, I'm probably just gonna braise them and make pasta sauce out of it. As for the rest of the head, tongue will probably be tacos. Brains, I don't know yet. I actually haven't cooked with brains. It's just fun to get it out of the head and show you guys.
Thank you so much for that explanation. I feel like we just went behind the curtain of how things work in the kitchen. So thank you, Mitch.
Thank you, guys. It was a lot of fun.
All right, I am pulling up my slideshow for our last special guest of the evening. While it is very hard to follow a butcher, as well as if you'll remember our third string NFL player, but many of you might indulge in shows or entertainment outside of NFL and watch something else on their Monday nights like I do. So while we don't have Chris Harrison from the Bachelor franchise, we have what I would consider the next best thing in our next special guest.
Hello, everybody from Chicago Coalition. This is Jorge the Bartender. I wanted to thank you, everybody, because of all the work that you have done for the homeless and for all the amazing work that you all do for Illinois. I know there is a lot of not very fortunate people that's what you guys are there for. I really appreciate what you guys are doing. You know what? Something I strongly believe, you gotta do the best for your brothers, sisters, that they need help. I know that you all are hosting a talent show fundraiser. So I wanted to participate and I wanted to be there. Hey, Chicago Coalition, thank you very much for your support. Please keep up the good work. Honestly, it is so nice. I mean, I love the cameos now because it's so nice to do messages like this for people like you. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. And you know one thing? Pay it forward. I strongly believe in that one. And I, please give me an update of how everything went. Take care of yourselves, everybody. Chicago Coalition, you're doing the right thing. And that is an amazing thing. Sophie Babcock, I hope I meet your expectations. Thank you, thank you. Be well. This is Jorge the bartender, and I do approve this message. Thank you.
Doesn't he just warm your heart? Love him. And what he said about paying it forward was very pertinent at this time, as we are at $14,900, only $100 away from reaching $15,000, which is $5,000 more than we anticipated to start this evening with. So please, 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 if you feel so inclined, help us reach our new goal that I just made up at $15,000 and help us reach that next goal with $100 more
Hello.
To the Chicago Coalition. We have two performances left of the evening. And so our next performer is Dan, and Dan is a stand-up comedian. Who grew up in Pittsburgh and moved to Chicago just last year, which I feel terrible about because Chicago was a lot more fun when we could actually leave our homes. And if you laugh at his jokes, you will be doing more charity than you realize. Dan, hello. How do you feel about me just stealing your joke in the last 5 seconds?
You told it better than I would. So great job, you know.
Joke, not mine, everybody. I have never heard him do stand-up, but I believe that you will laugh. So Dan, take it away.
Hey, great. Thank you. Thank you guys so much for coming. How about that butcher, huh? You know when you're watching a cooking show and you're just like, my pig face looks nothing like his. Man, I could not. I really messed this pig up, but oh well. This is pandemic hair. Let's start there. I don't always look like drunk Velma. Jinkies. But I do kind of like looking like this, though. I feel like when I have a nice haircut, I look too reliable. Like, I look like you could ask me for directions and I'm not just going to make something up, you know? Who needs the pressure? But I don't know. I am trying to change some stuff about my look. I've been getting into bodybuilding. I'm really good at it. I'm like the Pablo Picasso of bodybuilding, you know? Right now I'm working on getting my arms and legs to switch places. Trying to turn one of my pecs into a mandolin. It's pretty hard. But no, it is weird. I've been trying to work out. It's so... trying to lose weight and stuff. My bank really doesn't think I can do it. The day I joined the gym, fraud prevention called me. That was rough. My bank was like, this wasn't you, was it? Uh-oh, that's not salami. I used to be in much better shape, believe it or not. Like, I was really good at youth sports. But then they found out I'm 24.
That's funny. Like,
hey, ref, that homeschool kid is enormous. Did he drive himself here? There's no way. Anyway, welcome to my apartment. Thank you guys so much for coming. Blue. I don't mean to brag, but I live in a really historic part of town, actually. Just half a block from me is the First Methodist Church. Oh my god. Blaze must be able to tell. I know I'm weird. I'm sorry. I know. It's not my fault. I'm from a weird family, you know? Okay. They're weirder than I am. My sister-in-law is against race mixing. Can you believe it? She will not go to a triathlon. So he's like, you want to run? You want to bike? You want to swim? Pick one. Stop mixing these races. Girl, that is not what that means. We are in public right now. Anyway, my great uncle's weird too. He told me one time, you know, I went to school with the guy who killed JFK. I was like, you went to school with the military industrial complex? That must have been weird. No. But it turns out he was talking about Lee Harvey Oswald. Because he doesn't know what happened. But no, it's crazy. He's got like childhood stories of Lee Harvey Oswald, you know? Like hitting the teacher with spitballs from impossible distances and stuff. Getting set up. All the other kids are like, what kind of straw is that? Can it even fire that fast? And the teacher's like, shut up, do your homework. But I don't know. I wasn't good at school. My favorite class in college was philosophy. I didn't even like philosophy that much. I just really enjoyed watching 19-year-olds disagree with the greatest thinkers who have ever lived. Like, all right, Plato versus Stephanie, let's go. Get them, Steph, what you got? She's like, the cave is stupid. And you're like, oh, Plato's not coming back from this one. All right. Well, anyway, thank you guys so much for coming out and donating. I know that laughing at these jokes feels like charity enough, but I really do appreciate you guys helping me fight the homeless or whatever. I'm Dan Docimo. Thank you very much. You guys have been wonderful.
Amazing, Dan. It's so nice to see you perform. Obviously, a lot of us have never met you in person, but my boyfriend and I were just saying, we want to be friends with that guy. Whatever you're saying is working for the majority of the group here. So thank you so much for your time.
Oh, thank you. You have very poor judgment.
You're good on your feet too. You even had the butcher joke ready. I don't know if you remembered you were going to be performing after him or what, but that was great. All right. So our last performance of the evening is going to be by Tabitha Rooney. She's our last performer. So before she jumps in, I do just want to say that we're tallying up our fundraising element of the scores now. So as soon as she's done, that's the last point in time that your participant can get more points for your fundraising donation. But the fundraising pages will stay open. So just in case you don't get your donation in time in the next 5 minutes, that doesn't mean you cannot go to an individual fundraiser's page and donate after the fact. It just will not be taken into account in their score. So with that being said, Tabitha is a singer and actor who moved to Chicago in 2016. She'll be singing Once More I Can See from the Broadway musical Wonderland. Tabitha, thank you for rounding out our show tonight. Are you ready to jump in?
Yes, I am. Here we go. Awesome.
I have to ask, how did you hear about CCH or get involved?
I work for a company called Tab Service Company, not mine, just funny that it is my name. And they do some printing for CCH, and I just recently finished with the first ever student and young professional cohort. We were promoting the Fair Tax Amendment. And now I'm here.
Now I hope that you're a CCH lifer because you've already helped the coalition so much. And we are so thankful for you dedicating your time for the show. So I will let you take it away.
Okay, here we go. Thank you to everybody for donating. Without further ado. Oh. Long ago and oh so far away, there are dreams that I recall, full of unicorns who love to play behind my garden wall. And the clouds, they looked like dragon's tails as they moved across the sky. And a tree could be the Prince of Wales, and little girls could fly. I remember every moment, how it was to just be free. And to my surprise, I look through your eyes, and once more I can see. And I remember living in between what was real and what was not, neath a sky of blue and field of green I long ago forgot. And I remember rabbits running late underneath my mother's fence, and a singing cup and talking plate who somehow both made sense. I remember every moment, I remember being free. And to my surprise, I look through your eyes, and once more I can see. For somewhere deep inside me, there's a girl from way back when. She just needs your heart to guide me and make her see again. I remember every moment when my heart was young and free. And to my surprise, I looked through your eyes. And once more,
woo, go Tabitha! Yeah. Amazing!
Amazing!
Woo, go yeah. Tabitha!
Nice!
Bye. Woo.
Tabitha, amazing! Thank you so much. That was so beautiful. Great way to round out the show. So thankful for you. Thank you for your participation and everybody who has been a contestant tonight. We are so thankful for you. Everybody who's still on the line, we are over 100 people still, which is amazing. You spent your evening with us. I'm gonna go back to sharing my screen so that I can let you know that at this point, all of the scores are being tallied. While all of the fundraising pages, like I mentioned, will stay open through the evening and beyond. While our judges tally up those scores to announce the top three contestants as well as the overall winner. We will now hear a special rendition by Molly Brennan of The Wizard of Oz. She's performing the whole show in under 5 minutes. So take that how you might, but you're about to witness it. She created this for the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless for our 40th anniversary this year. We thought we have to play this again. It hits home for so many. Our theme for the anniversary celebration, which was moved to virtual, was There's No Place Like Home. So it really embodies all that CCH stands for. We believe housing is a human right and that there is truly no place like home. So without further ado, I'll let Molly Brennan take us through The Wizard of Oz in under 5 minutes as the judges tally their scores.
The Wizard of Oz in 5 minutes. Go find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble. Suppose there is such a place somewhere over the rainbow. I speak to you about Dorothy. I'm nearly lame for the bite of my leg. She bit you? No, her dog. She bit her dog? No, I am ordered to take that mangy mutt. Oh, don't let it take him. Go away, you're nothing but a wicked old witch. Huh? Oh, Toto, you
you got away. They'll be coming for us. We need to run away. Please, Professor, can you take us to see the crowned heads?
Do you know any? Looks like there's a storm coming. Poor kid. Hope she makes it home okay. It's a twister. It's a twister. Dorothy, Auntie Em, Uncle Henry. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch. Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. Are you a good witch or a bad witch? Well, I'm not a witch at all. We represent the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild. She's not only merely dead, she's really most sincerely dead. Ding dong, the witch is dead, witch, oh witch, the wicked witch. Give me back my ruby slippers. Oh, you have no power here. Be off before someone drops a house on you. Oh, I can't attend you here and now, but I'll get you, my pretty and little dog, too. Poof! Oh, what a smell of sulfur. People come and go so quickly here. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Well, some people go both ways. Did you say something? I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain, if I only had a brain. Come with me to see the wizard. He said oil can. Oil can what? When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, and yet I want a heart, if I only had a heart. Come with us to see the wizard. Lions and tigers and bears, oh my, put them up, oh, what to do that for, I didn't buy them, I guess there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, without the vim and vibe, if I only had the knife, come with us to see the wizard, we're up to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz, it's the Emerald City, we're almost there, poppies, hey, look, it's snowing. Unusual weather we're having. You're out of the woods, you're out of the dark, you're out of the night. Who rang that bell? Ha, 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 ho, 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 and a couple of tra-la-las. Surrender, Dorothy. I am the great and powerful Oz. I am Dorothy, small and meek. Bring me the broomstick of the wicked witch. But then we'd have to kill her. I'd turn back if I were you. I got a plan to get Dorothy out of there, and you're gonna lead us. Oh, wee-oh, wee-oh. The hourglass is almost empty. Leaving so soon, I wouldn't hear of it. Have a little fire, Scarecrow. Oh, no, don't throw that water. Oh, I'm melting. What a world. She's dead. You've killed her. The broomstick, may we have it? Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Why, you're nothing but a humbug. Well, you've cut me to the quick. I guess I'll have to take you back to Kansas myself. Oh, no, Professor, please don't leave without me. Now I'll never get home. You've always had the power to go home. She has. Now I know I have a heart because it's breaking. I'll miss you most of all, Scarecrow. I'm ready now. Just click your heels together 3 times and repeat. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There, there, dear, it was just a bad dream. Oh, but it wasn't a dream. There, and you, and it's all so beautiful. Oh, but Auntie Em, there's no place like home. Somewhere over the rainbow. The end.
All right, so I know I said that was The Wizard of Oz in under 5 minutes. I think it's about 4 minutes and 13 seconds. I can't remember the actual time frame there, but amazing performance, even though she's not here with us in person. We were glad that she allowed us to present that to everybody tonight. But again, the scores are in. And I know that Patrick, Sarah, Claire, all of our judges who have been entering your scores as we speak on our tally sheet have been doing great work trying to make sure that we have a quick turnaround for the winner. And I just got a text that we are all in on the scores. So I'm going to turn it over to Patrick and Sarah. They're going to be sharing the not only winner of the entire show, all of the winners tonight that have raised over $1,000 will get on the, like I said, CCH Wall of Fame. They'll have a placard with their name on it for raising $1,000 for the cause. And then we will have one winner or group of participants who were the top fundraising group. And then we will have a third place, a second place, and a first place. So I'm gonna just go ahead and kick it over to Patrick and Sarah to announce the results.
Sophie, drum roll, please. Drum roll. Do you need a drum roll?
How is it? All right. So thank you all again for joining us. We're so excited that this went off with such a hit. So we're going to, like Sophie said, talk about the Wall of Fame recipients and also the top fundraisers. So Patrick, do you want to talk, or no, I forgot what we were doing. So for the top fundraisers for individuals, we have Tabitha, John Egan, and Liz Hines. So a round of applause for our top individual fundraisers. Thank you all for the amazing work that you did fundraising for the Chicago Coalition for the Homeless. We couldn't do what we do without you guys. And then we have the Wall of Fame participants. So for those in for those people who have raised over $1,000, you will be added to the CCH Wall of Fame. This is a very high honor. If you don't know about it, now you do. It's something that in fundraisers past, people have been added to this Wall of Fame as well. So it is something that people in the CCH world know a lot about, and it is very coveted. So congratulations to Tabitha, the Booth Men and David, John Egan, the Booth Women Who Like Pie, Liz Hines, Dan, Chloe, Alicia. You have all earned a spot on the CCH Wall of Fame. So congratulations.
Yay! Woo!
And now I will turn it over to Patrick.
All right, yeah, so the top three. For third place, we have Dan DeSimo.
Yay!
Awesome!
For second place, we have John Egan.
Yay!
And first place, we have Tabitha Rooney.
Thank
you all so much. This was great.
Awesome. Well, we have our winner, Tabitha. How do you feel?
It feels so good, so relieved, so happy to have sung for people for the first time in, live in all this time, and so grateful for the opportunity. Thank you, Sophie, for all you've done, and thank you for everybody who donated and everybody who helped us get this far.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, so, so much. And the last thing that we're going to do tonight, I'm going to share my screen for the final time to share with everybody how much we raised. At this point in the game, we are at $15,900 raised when all we set out to do was raise $10,000, which seemed like a feat at the time. Thank you to all of the participants, to all of the awesome judges that we had, and to every single one of you that stayed with us throughout this whole 5-week journey to continue to support your participant in this show. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you to Claire and Michael from CCH, Doug from CCH. We could not have done this awesome show without your support. So I think we all deserve a round of applause before we jump off. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And remember, in these trying times, feel free to support CCH, continue to support your neighbor. They might need it more than you think. So with that, thank you, everybody, for joining, and we will end the show.
Thank you, Sophie.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.